In this video, we'll examine fixed exchange rates and see how they are managed. You should have a basic understanding of exchange rates and understand how they are determined. While you are not explicitly asked to understand the advantages and disadvantages of exchange rate systems, it is helpful to know. I'll make a couple points regarding this in the presentation. Fixed exchange rate systems occur when the government of a country fixes the value of its currency to another currency, a basket of currencies, or a commodity such as gold. I've put the image up of the Bahamas because many Caribbean islands peg or fix the value of their currency against the American dollar because they are heavily dependent on the US for tourism. A government operating a fixed exchange rate regime will intervene in the foreign exchange market or use the interest rate to influence the supply and demand for the currency. We'll define what happens when they aim to increase or decrease the value of the currency in the next slide. We'll then look at how it's done. When discussing the revaluation or devaluation of currencies, we are generally referring to fixed exchange rate regimes. Revaluation occurs when a government intervenes to increase the value of its currency relative to another. If a country sets its exchange rate to 2-to-1 against the dollar and then allows it to increase to 1-to-1, then we say that it has revalued. Devaluation occurs when a government intervenes to decrease the value of its currency relative to another. If a country sets its exchange rate to 1-to-1 against the dollar and then allows it to decrease to 2-to-1, then we say that it has devalued. Next, we'll see how a government actively intervenes to keep the exchange rate fixed. Although China no longer operates a fixed exchange rate regime, having moved over to a managed float system, we can actually use the country's currency history to help us understand the two different exchange rate systems. For this example, we will look at the period of time in which China fixed the value of the yuan to the dollar at about 8.28 to the dollar. This value held from 1994 to 2005. How it's changed since, we will look at in the next video. Imagine that the Chinese government wants to keep the value of the currency at ER star relative to the dollar. If $1 buys 8.28 yuan, then we know that 1 yuan equals $0.1208, or about 12.1 cents. I arrived at this figure by dividing $1 by 8.28. Suppose the demand for Chinese exports rises significantly and the yuan starts to strengthen against the dollar. This would make Chinese exports more expensive to American buyers and could potentially hurt the export-led growth and development the Chinese government pursued during that time frame. So in order to maintain stability in export markets, the Chinese government would intervene by increasing the supply of yuan in the foreign exchange market. This would decrease the value of the currency and it would return to its original exchange rate with the United States dollar. The government essentially takes actions to offset any increase or decrease in the exchange rate. If it wants to decrease the exchange rate, it sells off its own currency or the central bank takes action to decrease interest rates. If it aims to increase the exchange rate, the government could buy its own currency, limit how much can be exchanged in the foreign exchange market, or the central bank could choose to increase interest rates. The advantages of a fixed exchange rate system include the reduction in risk, which is associated with exchange rate fluctuations. Firms know what exchange rate to expect when conducting business abroad, and this can inform more long-term decision-making. Also, with a fixed exchange rate system, currency speculation is limited. If there is an expectation that the currency may be revalued or devalued, there's still the possibility of speculation. However, a fixed exchange rate regime is far less prone to speculation than a floating exchange rate system. The disadvantages of operating a fixed exchange rate regime include a loss of flexibility in responding to economic conditions. If the government chooses to decrease interest rates to increase aggregate demand within the economy, it must also consider the resulting impact on the exchange rate. In order to manage the value of their currency, a government may have to hold foreign currency reserves. Since they must hold reserves, there is an associated opportunity cost in that these reserves cannot be used for other purposes such as investment. If the central bank is changing interest rates to change the value of the exchange rate, this will also have an impact on the domestic economy. Changing interest rates also affect consumer and business behavior by increasing the cost of borrowing. Hopefully you've got a better understanding of fixed exchange rates and fixed exchange rate regimes. If you have any questions, please leave them below or email me at enhancedtuition@gmail.com. You can also tweet me at enhancedtuition and soon find me on my website, enhancedtuition.co.uk. As always, thanks for watching and I will see you in the next one.